Hello friends, good morning. Let's start our today's topic, change of independent variable. Here I have written the formula. If z is a function of xy and x is a function of uv and y is also a function of uv, then dou z by dou u is equal to dou z by dou x by dou u plus dou z by dou y into dou y by dou u, and dou z by dou v is equal to dou z by dou x into dou x by dou v plus dou z by dou y into dou y by dou v. Now, you no need to remember these formulas. Just find out the dependency. You can yourself write the formula. Okay. So, see here. Already what they said. Z is a function of xy. Write down. Z is a function of xy. And x is a function of uv and y is also a function of uv. So, you can write here. Xy is a function of uv. Now to find the derivative of z with respect to u. Now here dependency of z is on two variable. And that two variable are also dependent on two variable. So more than one variable is their dependency. So whenever you are going to have the derivative, that all derivatives will be your partial derivatives. Okay. So for z with respect to u, that is your partial derivative here. Okay, so to find z with respect to u, first of all differentiate with respect to x and then x with respect to u. See here, plus then differentiate with respect to y and y with respect to u. Okay, so that will be your formula for dou z by dou u. Similarly, you can find dou z by dou v. So dou z by dou v is equal to first differentiate with respect to x and then x with respect to v. Okay. And then differentiate z with respect to y and then y with respect to v. This will give you the value for dou z by dou v. Okay. Whenever you are going to solve the examples on change of independent variable, first of all write down the dependency and according to that dependency find out the results. Okay. See here. I have written an example. If z is a function of xy, they said z is a function of xy, but they have not given a proper value for z in terms of x and y. Okay, so we'll consider only z is a function of xy. Okay, and x is equal to e raised to u plus e raised to minus v, and y is equal to e raised to minus u minus e raised to v. So we can say that x and y are functions of uv because the values of x and y are given in terms of uv. Okay, so according to that we can write here dependency. Z is a function of xy and xy is a function of uv, and again to find z with respect to u, z with respect to v, we are going to find a chain rule. Okay, but now here observe this you have to prove. So derivatives here are z with respect to u, z with respect to v, z with respect to x and z with respect to y. Okay. So whatever the dependency is there, according to that you are going to find the results first. Okay. So here z with respect to u is z with respect to x, x with respect to u plus z with respect to y, y with respect to u. And to find z with respect to v, z with respect to x, then x with respect to v, z with respect to y, and then y with respect to v. Okay. So here are your two formulas that you have to solve. Next. Now see how you are going to find these all terms. Already z is given to you. It is a function of xy. But we don't have a proper value. So whenever we differentiate this with respect to x and with respect to y, that will be your derivatives, z with respect to x and z with respect to y. Okay. But we are given terms, x is equal to e raised to u plus e raised to minus v. So we can differentiate x with respect to u and value is e raised to u. Also we can differentiate x with respect to v and value is e raised to minus v into minus 1. Okay, and after you solve it is minus e raised to minus v. So whenever you differentiate x with respect to u, v will be constant, and whenever you differentiate v with x with respect to v, then u will be a constant term. Okay, similarly here you can see we have y is equal to e raised to minus u minus e raised to v. Again, we can find derivative of y with respect to u. Keeping v constant, it is minus e raised to minus u. And y with respect to v, keeping u constant, it is minus e raised to v. Okay. Now, putting all these values here in equation 1 and 2, we get here z with respect to u, dou z by dou x into e raised to u plus dou z by dou y into minus e raised to minus u. We don't have the values for z with respect to x and z with respect to y. So that term will be as it is, and you can replace x with respect to u and x y with respect to u. Okay, according to formulae, you got the value for z with respect to u, e raised to u dou z by dou x minus e raised to minus u dou z by dou y. Similarly, from equation 2, you can write the term z with respect to v. Whenever you put the values of x and y with respect to v, you will get z with respect to v is equal to minus e raised to minus v z dou z by dou x minus e raised to v dou z by dou y. Okay, now solving, consider here left hand side. So we have the values z with respect to v and z with respect to u. So we are going to consider the left hand side, that is our dou z by dou u minus dou z by dou v. So putting the values of dou z by dou u and dou z by dou v, you have to make a bracket here because it is a negative sign, so it should go to all the terms. Okay, now open the bracket. If you open the bracket, sign will change here. All negative term will get positive then. Okay, then next, simplify the term here. After solving, see here, dou z by dou x, dou z by dou x, we can find common. Remaining is e raised to u plus e raised to minus v. Dou z by dou z by dou y common. Remaining is, also we are finding negative sign common. So e raised to minus u minus e raised to v is the remaining term. But these are the values for x and y. So this is your required right hand side. So we can say here, hence proved. Okay. Below I have written an example for homework that you can solve yourself. Again here, z is given to you a function of xy, where x is equal to e raised to u and y is equal to, x is equal to e raised to u cos v and y is equal to e raised to u sin v. And you have to show this. Again, first of all, find the dependency. Okay, I'll give you a hint. Z is depending on xy and xy is depending on, again here, u and v. So you can create your own formulas to solve this example. Okay, I hope friend, aapko mera ye video pasand aaya hoga. Okay, if you have any difficulty, you can